Hey, YouTube world, we are back. Hope you're having a great day so far. I'm excited to be back because I've been kind of bouncing in and out of the YouTube videos because I've been waiting for some kind of breaking news to come in, and boy, did we get it. We got breaking news, people, because Cam Newton is going to the Patriots, and everything that people previously thought about the AFC East is getting tossed out the window now. To be clear, people are overreacting like crazy. First and foremost, it's still up in the air what the AFC East is going to look like. Buffalo could easily be the division champs, even though we've done YouTubes and podcasts about how I think the Bills could be one of the more overrated teams in the NFL this year. The Patriots are obviously right in the thick of things. The Dolphins can win the division if they get division victories against the Bills and the Patriots. It's an entire possibility. Things are still up in the air, and Cam Newton doesn't change everything in the AFC East, considering that the Patriots may have upgraded at quarterback, but their big question is still how good the defense is going to be, which I don't have the answers to those questions. I assume they're not going to fall to 15, but I also don't think they'll be number one like last year, considering Stephon Gilmore was Defensive Player of the Year in the NFL, and they had like four really good players on defense leave, even though those guys were like Van Noy, Jamie Collins, and like guys that are pretty replaceable, I would say. So that's the stepping stone for the Patriots. And I think that what we're seeing is kind of the culmination of Cam Newton's long, tumultuous offseason, because everyone knew he was talented when he was healthy. But the fact that you have to say the when he's healthy part tells you a lot about where Cam Newton stands at this point. So all I can focus in on is the fact that this move makes the Patriots better in the short term, because I talked about this today, like, I can't believe we spent 3 months thinking Jarrett Stidham was the guy. Like, we wasted so much time talking about Jarrett Stidham. I was calling him Jared for like 2 months. I knew it was Jarrett. I just called him Jared for 2 months. It was only like in May that I started correcting myself, because I assumed they would just get a quarterback. Now, I thought it was going to be Andy Dalton, and I thought that was seemed like a perfect match made in heaven. Andy Dalton going to the Patriots and leading them to the AFC Championship game. Cam Newton is right up there, and actually Cam Newton has had more career success than Andy Dalton. So I think the Patriots are still, I had the Patriots as the front runners to win the weakest division in the AFC. I had them as the front runners before, I still have them as the front runners now, but it doesn't slide the scale very much. And the only way we're going to be able to know who's going to win the AFC East, watch the games between AFC East opponents. Do the Bills go into Miami and get a win? Does Miami go into New York and get a win against the Jets? Can the Jets go into Buffalo and get a win? Can the Jets go into Miami to get a win? Whoever wins the divisional games will pull away a division where it feels like the four teams are separated by like four games. And it's rare that you have a division like that. Last year, I thought that was going to be the case in the NFC North, and I was proven correct until the Packers went 6-0 in their division. That proved to be the difference maker, and the reason the Packers were five games better than the Bears. Same situation is going to happen this year with the top of the NFC West. Does Arizona go into Seattle and win? Does Seattle go to San Francisco? Can San Francisco win in Arizona? Does anyone sweep the season series against each other? Whoever wins the division games will give you the inclination of who wins, because we can see it on paper. Like I said, it feels like the four teams in the AFC East are separated by about four games on paper, but we'll see how what happens when they face off with each other. Unfortunately, we're going to get some of those matchups early in the season, assuming that the season happens and isn't modified because of COVID-related reasons. Because again, I don't think there's a good chance that any of these leagues finish their seasons. I think that they will start the seasons, but I think finishing is a really difficult proposition, especially in football, where an entire team could get wiped out for a week's game and the NFL can't really proceed. So, stepping stones on that front, but Cam Newton is obviously better than Jarrett Stidham. Now, I've heard myself say, but also not verified in very many places, I've been saying that Cam Newton to Kyle Allen last year replicated very similar numbers to what the Panthers were. They were a 7-9 to 6-10 team coming out the gate. They finished 5-11 after Cam Newton went down for the season, and the last three games were after Ron Rivera was fired, and the defense just gave up on the season. And Penny Sewell, I think, was the coach. Still not 100% sure on that. But they were about the same team with Cam Newton, or projected with Cam Newton and without Cam Newton. About the same situation. And I feel like the same thing is going to happen with Cam Newton versus Jarrett Stidham. They would have been just in the same category they were. I think if you had the Patriots winning the division before, you're still feeling good about it. If you had the Bills winning the division before, you're feeling less good about it, but you're still feeling like Buffalo can win the division and will ultimately win the division if you're willing to be that decisive in or on June 29th of 2020 when the regular season ends 6 months from today. So if you're willing to put yourself in that confident of a position, you're probably not changing either way based on the Cam Newton signing. And I think that's probably the smartest thing you can do, because I don't think it'll be MVP Cam Newton. I don't think it'll be 30 touchdown Cam Newton. But I think it's going to be better than what Tom Brady was at the end of last season. And that's not even a crazy statement. Tom Brady was Trubisky level at the end of last season. The last 10 games, he was as bad as Mitchell Trubisky in terms of completion percentage, in terms of quarterback rating, in terms of INT to touchdown ratios. Like, he was bad at the end of last season. And Cam Newton's going to be better than that. I don't think he's a 30 touchdown guy, and I don't think he's an MVP guy. Is he enough to win that division? We'll see what happens, because again, he should be fully healthy. He's not going to have played football in 12 months, and that was enough to get Andrew Luck back from no one knows what's wrong with his shoulder to a 35 touchdown guy just from having 12 months. Well, really, for him, it was more 18 months of not playing football. For Cam Newton, get rid of the two games from last year, it's about the same length of time Andrew Luck had off of football. And that should be enough for Cam Newton to recover. Then again, Andrew Luck had the surgeries months in advance of Cam Newton, so he had more time to recover. Cam Newton being a shoulder and a foot, Andrew Luck being a shoulder and I forgot if it was a back. I forgot what the other injury to Andrew Luck was. Calf. Calf was the other Andrew Luck injury. Shoulder and a calf. For Cam Newton, it was shoulder and a foot injury. So I don't think he'll be the 30 touchdown guy, and I don't think this changes that much in terms of, on paper, the Patriots, Bills, Jets, and Dolphins are all within 4 games of each other. But that doesn't mean that they'll even be first place and third place will be within 5 games. We saw it last year with the Packers and the NFC North. They did their job in the division, went 6-0 in the division and crushed the entire competition. I don't know. I don't think any team will do that in the AFC East, but if they do, that's going to be the 3-game edge that they have on the rest of the division. So this is an interesting situation. I'm just happy to be able to talk about sports again. So without further ado, talk to you again later.